And now we're seeing the fruits of that legislation. And we're seeing it implemented, and we're seeing it operationalized, and we see it working. And it's fascinating to see. You know, it's almost like watching the progress of a child, right? You birth the piece of legislation and you work through it, but then you see it in actual development and you see the energy that it's creating in the local community, and that's what it's all about. And the pieces are coming together. You can feel it. They're starting to reinforce each other, and this state is on a fundamentally different trajectory than it was on, and I credit my colleagues with that.
And to my colleague, Tom Libous, focused, tenacious, never gives up on Binghamton University. We have a little bit of a challenge between the two of us in terms of hometown pride, Stony Brook, Binghamton University. We love them both because I think half the kids from Long Island go to Binghamton University, which is wonderful.
Binghamton's Smart Energy Initiative addresses state and national needs for cleaner, more efficient energy. Our researchers are making solar power economically competitive by developing new technologies for the production of next-generation thin-film solar panels. We're creating solar-powered devices that can be easily incorporated in consumer goods, such as roofing panels that generate electricity or cell phones that never need recharging.
The presentation talks about not only smart energy, which is something we should get very excited about. It is a different project. Unlike any other project that I think is being taken up throughout the system. And we talked about jobs, we talked about opportunities. I have to say that Binghamton University has been a great economic engine, not only through the partnerships that both Jay and Diana talked about this morning, but also the students that spend money in our community from Long Island, Leader, and we appreciate that. Just to tell you a quick story, there's a local diner I go to called the Park Diner, and my wife and I have been going. It's kind of called the Libous Hangout. Well, I have to tell you, over the last several years, we can't get in on Saturday and Sunday after church. We have to wait because there's lines of university students, and we want to continue that sort of thing in the community. But this project, Governor, is going to not only create jobs, it's going to produce careers. And I salute you for that, because that's what we're trying to do here. Jobs are one thing, and they're important, but creating careers is what this program at Binghamton University is going to do.
Using SUNY not just as the academic engine, but as the economic engine. And our plan for the state, our New York Open for Business plan, basically works on two tracks. Number one, doing statewide reforms to generate the economy. But we also recognize that the economy works on a regional level, a local level, and we believe a catalyst for those regional economic development plans can be the SUNY system.
For my dear friend and colleague, Tom Libous, he is tenacious and he bleeds Binghamton, whatever the colors are.
We all bleed, he made us all bleed Binghamton.